Okay, this 1-inch pipe, this is going to form the legs that's going to get, you know, socketed down into the 1¼-inch pipe. That's one of my favorite sleeve techniques. So these are the pieces that are going to get welded onto the bottom. And so what I do here is, this is kind of one of my little fabrication tricks, is I'll drill part way through with the hole saw, about, you know, 3/4 of the way. Then I'll come back in here while I've still got this piece together, since it's a pain to deal with round pieces on the tapping machine, on my hand tapper. So now I've come in here and I've cut threads. I did this with the hole saw. That was a 1/4-inch thing. Drilled it out with a 5/16, which is the drill size for 3/8. Tap 3/8. Now I'm just going to come in here and free these guys. But before I do that, I'm probably going to come in here with the grinder while I have these pieces together, and hit them with the grinder so they're clean on both sides. I think I can free them enough where I don't have to use more cutting fluid to get them out. And so all I have to do is just clean them up just a little bit. But I always prefer to deal with things like this, just like I did with the long piece with all the plate. You do all your drilling and stuff first before you cut it apart, then it's just easier to handle on the drill press and safer and more efficient. Again, you can see how easy this is if you leave the pieces together before you finally cut them apart. So all I'm going to have to do is, you know, basically just kind of make sure that I clean off any residue with thinner before I weld. You know, wire wheel it a little bit maybe, but it's a pretty good way to do it. It's easier to hang on to those little pieces. Well, I did have to use cutting fluid again because I just can't, it just wouldn't free these out. This bit's a little bit dull and it's not clearing those chips. But one thing you'll notice is that whenever you do this hole saw work, you always want to try to cut on the edge if you're trying to cut these, free these discs, because it gives the chips somewhere to escape to. And it just makes cutting a lot more efficient. You can see them coming out right here. But now the pilot of the hole saw isn't really doing anything because it already had the circumference for it to guide it. So I'm not touching my tapped piece in here. But look at all those chips. Just if you give it away for it to escape, so much more efficient for the waste to escape the chips. And of course you get out your trusty plug poppers. And there it is. It's free. Ready to move on to the next one. So I'll just soak those. I'll just clean them up with some simple green and, you know, soap and water or what have you, some degreaser. I've got to get some degreaser anyway for some of the other stuff. So I'll take care of that. They'll just get soaked before they get welded. I got to grind on them a little bit anyway. Grind bevel. Okay, so I'm getting these ready to get welded onto the bottom of the pipe. I have some cleanup to do on this, of course, and I've got to bevel a little bit. But this is now the setup that's ready to get welded on. So the bevel here will be right on the bottom of the pipe, so I'll have a place for penetration. There'll be another bevel there. There's going to be a nut on the inside, so the first thing I'll do is I'll weld the nut to this thing. Then I'll just come in here, put this here, and weld it. Then I can take this bolt out and then just run my tap back through it. So this is the way I dealt with them. Here, let me set this one aside so I don't get confused. This is the way I dealt with them on the when I was grinding it on the bench grinder. So you can see I've got it's actually the wrong way. The nut needs to be on this side for welding. But after I was done grinding this, I went out and hit everything again with the purple silicone carbide pad. So this is completely ready to weld right now. So, you know, just a little bit of a little bit of fussing, you know, just loosen that up. Now this needs to be on the inside, so I'll just run this thing through here. I'm not really worried about little junk in there because I'm going to clean it out with the tap. That one's a little tight though. That's enough. Oh, maybe just a little bit more. That looks good. Okay, so that's ready to stick on here, and once this pipe is ready to weld it, and then now I've got a nice 3/8 inch threaded receiver that's fortified by a nut inside it for my feet to go on to, my leveling feet, my shop-made leveling feet that I'm making. Thanks for watching. We have woodworking plans available in our store and will continue to add more. Each set of plans corresponds with a free video series available on YouTube.